y'all had a blessed morning and day so far. Because I'm looking forward to this program my own self. We're going to ask everyone that's able to, if you'll stand and join in with our guest choir in our opening selection, Blessing Assurance.
Bow here for a word of prayer. Oh, Father God, thank you for this beautiful day you have made for us, Father. Yes, let us be glad in this day and rejoice in this day, Father. Yes, Lord. Oh, Father God, bless St. Louis on their Deacon and Deacon's Day and Trustee, Father. Yes. Guide them, Father. Lead them, protect them, keep them in your keeping care.
Yes, yes.
Oh, Father God, bless the sick and the shut in.
Yes.
Those who want to make it but could not make it, Father. Uh-huh. And bless those overseas fighting that never ending battle.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Deaconess and Trustees. We start off with the deacons, Deacon Russell Morton, Jr., Deacon Rapp, C. Graham, Sr., Deacon Hubert Jones, Deacon Louie Braxton, Deacon Clement Daniel, Deacon Herman East, Deacon Philip East, Deacon Cornell Banks, Deacon Hubert Sneed, Deacon Samuel Gordon, and Deacon Hazel Dunn. The next one, Deaconess. And that would be our mature season. The old Jones. And the last one, Trustee, Deacon Hubert Jones, Deacon Mr. Will Terry, Mr. Ressie Russell Morton, Sr., Mr. Winston Sullivan, Deacon Hazel Dunn. Let's go.
Good night.
Oh, I can read the trustee's name there. Trustee Arthur Evans Jr.
Anyway, thank you, Sister Banks and Deaconess Smith for that. We will now have our welcome coming from Deaconess Rosa Morton.
Hello, Saints.
Hello. Hello.
First of all, I'd like to give honor to my Lord and Savior.
Good night.
Special honor to our pastor, Mr. Fleshman. our Pastor Wolford.
Bless you.
Our honorary guest, First Lady Mrs. Fleshman, Mrs. Wolford. And if there are any other First Ladies here, we'd like to welcome you. All right. Deacons, Deaconess, special guests, and family members. And for our special guests here, we would like to give you a special welcome.
Welcome, welcome. You are welcome. You are welcome at St. Louis. Welcome, welcome.
Yes.
Truly welcome.
Same.
You are welcome here today. Welcome, welcome. You are welcome. You are welcome. That's St. Louis.
All right.
Always welcome.
Yes.
Truly welcome. You are welcome. When you walk through that door,
yeah.
Welcome.
I know.
Truly welcome.
Mm-hmm.
Always welcome. At St. Louis. You are welcome.
Yeah.
Truly welcome. Now stand up and shake someone's hand. Tell them welcome. You are welcome. Say welcome. You are welcome here today. Truly
Deaconesses and Trustees by Deaconess Mary.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Deaconess, everyone. I'm glad you did decide to come. The history of the deacons, deaconess, and trustees of St. Louis Baptist Church. I'm going to start off with me, myself. I, 1982, Pastor Henry Guthrie of the Galilee Baptist Church, Randolph, Virginia, along with my husband, who was ordained and laid hands on, I was laid hands on to become a deaconess. So this is my 36th year.
Amen.
And the deaconess that we have here on our board at St. Louis, or we really don't have a board at St. Louis Baptist Church, would you stand my calling name? We have Deaconess Martha Brogdon, Deaconess Chris Evans, Deaconess Pearl White, Deaconess Francis Graham, his aunt, Deaconess Rosa Morton, Deaconess Gloria Roster, she's Deaconess Pauline Morton. She is a member, just like I'm with my husband's church, she is with my brother's church, Russell Morton III.
Amen.
Okay, you may be seated. From the Deacons, 1984, under the leadership of Reverend Richard Lowe, Deacon Russell Morton Jr. III was ordained here at the St. Louis Baptist Church. April 1987, under the leadership of Reverend John Evans, there were five deacons who were ordained. Deacon Douglas Randolph, Deacon Ralph Brown, Deacon Arthur Evans Jr., Deacon Robert D. Morton, and Deacon Robert Foster Jr. On November the 29th, 2009, Pastor Haney Thomas ordained two deacons, Deacon Ronnie Sneed and Deacon Tyron Roster, and that's when we had Deaconess Mary Morton-Smith at that time. The present deacons that we have here at St. Louis Baptist Church, Deacon Douglas I. Randolph is the chairman of the Deacon Board, Deacon Ronnie Sneed, Vice Chairman of Deacon Boards, Deacon Robert D. Morton, Deacon Russell Morton III, Deacon Robert Foster Jr., Deacon Tyron Walster. Those are the deacons here at St. Louis Baptist Church. Under the leadership of Reverend Haney Thomas Jr., there were five trustees that were bonded. The following names: Mr. Reginald Schufer, would you stand? Mr. Nathaniel Sneed, Mrs. Phyllis G., Mr. Ronnie Sneed, and Ms. Mabel Randolph. On March the 2nd, 2016, Trustee Martha B. Hughes was appointed to serve as trustee under the leadership of Pastor Reverend Henry L. Fleshman Jr. Then we have trustee board. Our trustee board, Trustee Ronald Schufer, president. Trustee Ronald Sneed, vice president. Trustee Phyllis G. Trustee Martha B. Hughes. Trustee Nathaniel Sneed. Trustee Russell Morton III. And that will end. Did I call your name for Deaconess? All right, Deaconess Martha B. Hughes is Deaconess. Her husband was made deacon at the Mount Ellis Baptist Church. What year?
My God.
Next time, I apologize. She is a deacon here at St. Louis Baptist Church. With my understanding, if you don't get ordained here at the St. Louis Baptist Church, if your husband is a deacon, then you are considered to be one also. Amen. That's where I got mine from, Galilee Baptist Church. Thank you, Galilee family. Thank you, Reverend Lindsay.
Thank you, Deacon and Smith. Giving my knees a workout standing up all that many times. And now we're going to move along. We're going to have a specific role of a deacon coming to us by Deacon Royal Freeman from Lawson Ford Baptist Church. You
don't
have to say?
No.
I'll give all honor and praise to our Father, Jesus the Christ, the pastor of this church, guests, ministers, and pastors, the usher board, choirs, members, and friends. It's a pleasure for me to be here. I thank Miss Deaconess Smith for inviting me. I don't know why, but she did. and I said yes. My job today is to talk a little bit about the role of the deacon and give you a little history of the deacon, and maybe I can bring you up to date. You always get to know your history before you can go into the future. So let me give you a little bit of history about the deacon. They say the word deacon comes from the word Deaconess, which means one who executes and commands of another, especially of a master, a servant, an attendant, or minister. But you go into Acts chapter 6, verse 1 through 7 in the King James Version. It says, seven chosen to serve. Key word is served. As a deacon, you are a servant. Now in those days, when the number of the disciples were multiplying, there arose a complaint against the Hebrews because their widows were neglected in daily distribution. The 12 summons the multitude of disciples and said, it is not desirable that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. Therefore, brethren, seek out from among you seven men of good reputation, full of the Holy Spirit and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business, but we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. And saying, please, the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Spirit, and Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas from Antioch, whom they set before the apostles. And when they had prayed, they laid hands on them. Then the word of God spread, and the number of disciples multiplied greatly in Jerusalem. And a great many of the priests were obedient to the faith. Then we get into the New Testament, Timothy, chapter 3, verse 8 through 15. It said, qualifications of the overseers. This is a faithful saying. If a man desires the position of a bishop, he desires a good thing. Likewise, must the deacons be grave, not double-tongued, not given much wine, not greedy or filthy lucre, holding the mystery of faith in a pure conscience. And let these also first be proven, then let them use the office of a deacon, being found blameless. Even so, the wise must be grave, not slanderous, sober, faithful in all things. Let the deacons be the husband of one wife, ruling their children and their own houses well. For they have used his office of a deacon, well purchased himself a good degree, and great boldness in the faith which is in Christ Jesus. These things I write unto you, hoping to come unto you shortly. But if I tarry long, that they may know us, thou art hath be thyself in the house of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillar, the ground of truth. We go back to Acts. There was three qualifications. They were saying, the first one was good reputation. They should be known morally, spiritually, faithful, and Christian living inside and outside of the church. They should be full of the Holy Spirit, but of the fruit of the Spirit, love, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithful, gentleness, and self-control inside the church and outside of the church. The third thing, full of wisdom. He must have knowledge, wisdom of his life, knowledge of God and his word, and good judgment. They said Stephen and Philip, they were full of faith and full of the Holy Spirit. Deacons should have knowledge of the Bible, rightly dividing the word of truth. Deacons should have knowledge of the church bylaws. Deacons should visit the sick. Deacons should get along with the pastor. Amen. If the pastor and deacon get along, the church will fall in.
Amen.
Deacons, we are servants. First, we need to serve the Lord, then serve the church and the family. Closing, for these, taken from Timothy chapter 3, verse 13, for these who have served well as deacons obtain for themselves a good standing and a great boldness in the faith, which is in Christ Jesus. I'm going to end my little role of deacon with a joke I just heard yesterday. It was this woman and man who was married, and so the woman went to Food Lion, and she had a problem. She stole a can of peaches out of the store. Anyway, she stole the peaches. Anyway, she got caught, and she went to court, and the judge asked her about the peaches. She agreed, yes, she stole the peaches. And the judge said, how many peaches were in the can? And the lady said, it was 6 peaches in the can. Okay, he said, I'm going to give you a year for each peach. So you got 6 years. said, the husband got up and said, Your Honor, can I say anything? He said, yeah, you can say one thing. He said, but you forgot, she stole a can of peas also.